There comes a time when one must take a position that is neither safe nor politic nor popular, but he must take it because conscience tells him it is right. The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy. A nation that continues year after year to spend more money on military defense than on programs of social uplift is approaching spiritual doom. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. One of the greatest liabilities of history is that all too many people fail to remain awake through great periods of social change. Every society has its protectors of status quo and its fraternities of the indifferent who are notorious for sleeping through revolutions. Today, our very survival depends on our ability to stay awake, to adjust to new ideas, to remain vigilant, and to face the challenge of change. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live up to the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. We must live together as brothers or perish together as fools. Never forget that everything Hitler did in Germany was legal. I have a dream that one day little black boys and girls will be holding hands with little white boys and girls. One has a moral responsibility to disobey unjust laws. Life's most persistent and urgent question is what you're doing for others. We must come to see that the end we seek is a society at peace with itself, a society that can live with its conscience. Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter. I have decided to stick to love. Hate is too great a burden to bear. Let no man pull you so low as to hate him. An individual who breaks a law that conscience tells him is unjust and who willingly accepts the penalty of imprisonment in order to arouse the conscience of the community over its injustice is in reality expressing the highest respect for the law. In the end, we will remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends. 300 years of humiliation, abuse, and deprivation cannot be expected to find voice in a whisper. The ultimate logic of racism is genocide. And if one says that one is not good enough to have a job, that is a solid quality job. If one is not good enough to have access to public accommodations, if one is not good enough to have the right to vote, if one is not good enough to live next door to him, if one is not good enough to marry his daughter because of his race, then at that moment, that person is saying, that person who is not good to do all of this is not fit to exist or to live. And that is the ultimate logic of racism. There comes a time when silence is betrayal. Nothing in the world is more dangerous than sincere ignorance and conscientious stupidity. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. If you cannot fly, then run. If you cannot run, then walk. If you cannot walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Faith is taking the first step, even when you cannot see the whole staircase. One day, the absurdity of almost universal human belief in the slavery of other animals will be palpable. We shall then have discovered our souls and become worthy of sharing this planet with them. There is some good in the worst of us and some evil in the best of us. When we discover this, we are less prone to hate our enemies. People fail to get along because they fear each other. They fear each other because they don't know each other. They don't know each other because they have not communicated with each other. Hatred paralyzes life. Love releases it. Hatred confuses life. Love harmonizes it. Hatred darkens life. Love illuminates it. An individual has not started living until he has risen above the narrow confines of his individualistic concerns to the broader concerns of all humanity.